Here's how you make a YouTube advertising campaign using Google AdWords. The great news is that you can consistently get global views for just 1 cent each that are great in terms of minutes watched and getting the video ranked high. So to me, knowing that going in is great motivation to do the work to make the ads. And you can get views for just 5 or 6 cents in the US, Canada, Australia, etc. The views themselves are usually worthless. So let's check this out to begin to set your expectations up properly. So what I've done is I've selected video campaigns, and this is all time. Now let's look at this. Cost $27,000 on YouTube ads. I've earned 20,000 views, got lots of watch time on here. Tons of people spend a lot of watch time, and ultimately, this is what gets you the high video ranking, is having this high watch time. That's where you get the video ranking. Now, let's look at how much this has converted. Yes, it's incredible, isn't it? If you looked at the cost per conversion, you'd think I'm insane. $926 for one conversion. You might think you are crazy. Here's the thing. All of the conversions happen when the video is ranked higher organically. The problem with YouTube ads is that the people who see them are not in the mood to buy. They're often not the right person to make the sale. However, they often will watch a lot of the ad for one reason or another. Or they'll let the ad run and click a new window open, and it will artificially inflate the watch time. The bottom line is that the watch time from the ads themselves are extremely valuable. So you can plan your ads to be a total loss, a complete loss, as long as you've got the organic traffic set up properly. Then you can get a huge benefit from the organic traffic. So for that $27,000 I've spent, I've easily made at least $100,000 in revenue and much more than that in actual sales. It's tricky though, because there's no good way to track it. So while most of what I say for Google AdWords is all about track it, track it, track it, YouTube ads is the one exception where you're not going to track it. You just need the watch time. You just need, and I'll go back to video campaigns, all you really need is this views. You need the views right here. The video needs to get played consistently to 25%. And preferably a good percent to 100. Now, if the video's really long, most of the videos I've advertised are really long. So if you have a short video, you should be going to 100% at a pretty high rate. This works best with the really long video though. And here's how you create a campaign. It's pretty easy. You click on campaign, you go down to video. YouTube then will give you the option, and Google AdWords and YouTube, I say interchangeably here, because this is in Google AdWords. YouTube is owned by Google. So it's the same company we're working with either how. Anyhow. So I grabbed the video link here from my other tab, and I'm going to call this Fiverr, and then I want it USA Plus. So I want some views paid in the US, Canada, Australia, because that often helps to get a good ranking when there's some views in the US to help get some local search ranking just a little bit. Now I'm going to set this at about $25 a day because I can afford to completely throw it away while I see what kind of results it's getting. Remember, this is only on faith with YouTube ads. Almost nothing good's going to happen directly. What I will do is watch the organic traffic, so I'm going to need weeks to watch the organic traffic. And the hacking video, I spent hundreds of dollars per day on that one from the beginning because I knew the organic traffic was good. Now, based on my research so far on this, I have good reason to suspect the Fiverr organic traffic is good also, because I already have several success for Fiverr videos. I've already done this before with several other videos. So that's the budget. I know I get a lot of questions about that, so that's why I'm setting it $25 a day. If you want to just get started, you can set it as low as $1 per day, or $5 or $10 per day can make a huge impact on your channel in the long term. So what I'm doing here, I'm selecting the countries that I want to get these ads out to. So it's United States, UK, New Zealand, Australia, and Canada, the five I generally go to for making what you might call sales campaigns. So I set that up, and the last thing I check down here, I want to limit this campaign to one impression per day. I don't want Google to sit there and show one person, because Google does this to me all the time. Google will sit there and show me the same ad 5 or 10 times in one day. That's why I got YouTube Red, so I don't ever have to watch anyone else's ad. Google will sit there and show the same video ad to me over and over again. So I set that to make sure that doesn't happen. And now I set my ad groups up so I can differentiate by audience. So I'm going to do two different things. So this is very similar to making a regular AdWords campaign, with the difference being I'm using a video, so I don't have to make any other type of ad. And I put in-stream ad for this because that's what tends to work best. So you can see on the preview here, it comes up before a video starts, and then it has a visit display URL and a skip ad button. So those are the options the user has. So what I want to do is do this by audience. So I'm going to start with my remarketing audiences in here, and I'll put YouTube remarketing. So I'm going to show this to people who've already visited my channel before. And then the final URL, I'm going to put for the YouTube video itself, because if I put it for something else, if I put it for the actual course, the problem is that the course usually has a low likelihood of selling, the cost per click's pretty high, and yet I want to test that out. So actually I am going to switch it up here. I am going to put it to the actual course here. And that's going to give me the chance to test out this. So I try and test new things all the time. So here's an example. I'm going to right now test this out and try and send people to Udemy directly when they click on the ad in case they want to buy it. Now for the tracking template, I can also do affiliate marketing on here. So what I need to do then, I need to open my AdWords account back up and grab my affiliate tracking off another campaign so that any click I get, it goes into the affiliate tracking. So I can just go back to my campaign I created before for the Fiverr USA search. I go over to settings, I scroll down to the bottom, I go to edit, and then I just go in here, I select all, control C, or Command C on Apple, which technically is what I'm using. And then I drop the tracking template in right there. Now I could put this up at the higher level. I could put it at the campaign level too, but it's easy to just throw it in right here. So now if someone clicks, they'll go to udemy.com/Fiverr101. And then they also will have my affiliate in case they buy anything else on Udemy. So then down here, I select my cost per view. Now, since this is US, UK, Australia, and New Zealand, and Canada, I'm going to put 0.07 to allow me to get views for 7 cents or less on this. And then what I'll do, I go into the interests in here, and actually I don't want these interests, I want to do remarketing here. So I'll go, this is YouTube remarketing, so I'll put all these YouTube remarketing in here. And I click done, and I'll do this a little bit more so you can see it again in case I went too fast. So all I have to do now, I hit save ad group, and now I've got this ad group is created. I've got it remarketing to people who've already watched one of my YouTube videos. So if I go up here, and I actually want to rename this Fiverr YouTube USA Plus so I remember it's a video campaign. So I've got that now, this one ad group is 7 cents a view, and it's targeted to everyone who's watched my channel in any of the countries I selected. And now I can quickly scale this up and try some different audiences, because often just my remarketing alone is not going to get me enough people. With YouTube remarketing, you have to have a giant audience, because often you won't get enough of the people actually in your remarketing audience to watch on YouTube. So what I'm going to do here now is put all of my Udemy remarketing audiences in this one. I copied this ad group, pasted it over here. So I click into the ad group. You'll see the ad has to go through review just like everywhere else. And then I go over to video targeting. I go over to remarketing. And then what I do is delete all of these. So I select all of them, I hit remove, and now I click add remarketing in here. Now instead of the video list, what I do is I go to my AdWords remarketing lists, and now I can manually just click each one of these over in here. This will show to anyone who's visited my Udemy course within the last 90 days, any of them. And it will show to anyone who's visited my website in the last 90 days also. So that'll allow me, the people who've already heard of me before, to get a good chance of seeing this video on YouTube. Because the best way to spend my ad money, I've found, is to deepen my relationship with the people who've already seen me before. And the easy way to do that is with remarketing ads. So I hit save, so now I've got all these. And I can separate the results out by all of these too. And yet the easiest way is to just do it at the ad group level. So I then, when I see all these come in, I can sort by conversions or I can sort by views here. When I see all of the results come in, I can see how much of the video people are watching based on the broad audiences I've selected. And then all I have to do is go in and I can even further optimize within each one. So I'll make another one of these. So I'll zoom in. I hit copy there and now I'm hitting paste here. I'm pasting that original ad group I made and not the other one because I don't want to have to delete all of those individual interests I made. And so I've got two remarketing audiences, and now what I want to do, I want to go to Fiverr keywords here. So this time I'm going to actually do a different way of targeting it. And often it's hard to get impressions on YouTube sometimes, because when you do more narrow targeting on YouTube, it often doesn't do a very good job with the audience. There's not enough people. And the keywords often, when I put in these keywords, YouTube won't have very many people because every single video with that keyword has to be monetized. So if the video's not monetized, YouTube can't show ads on it. So when you often put keywords in like this, if the video's not monetized, I can't show any ads on it. So keywords often work really poor on YouTube. So what I'll do, I'll put these keywords in and hit find related keywords so Google can help me out. And then I'll hit add these keywords and I'll see if there's some other ones that Google recommends based on what I've already added. So right now, I don't have any other ones. So I'll just do these two keywords. Now the problem is, I'm not even likely to get that many impressions out of these. So I've put these keywords on here and yet there's a good chance that YouTube is not even going to show this ad that often. So then what I can also do on top of that, I can go copy this one more time. Because at $25 a day, even with a huge remarketing audience, as you've seen, I have hundreds of thousands in the Udemy and I've got millions in the YouTube remarketing. And then on the Fiverr keywords, you got to figure there's hundreds, thousands more. All that's not going to be enough even at $25 a day with the various costs. So what I do is I make one more broad category here. I go with a broad category and then I lower my max cost per view here. And at Canada especially, you can get some cheaper views. So the idea is, and I'll even raise it up a little bit here, because I want YouTube then to try and get these more valuable views in terms of people who've already seen me. I want YouTube to prioritize these, but then if it can't get me any views at all, I still want my budget to spend. So what I'll do, I remove these keywords, and then what I do here is go into interests, and then I click interests to get some actual reach on these ads. So then I have different options I can choose from. I can choose something like do-it-yourself first, or I can choose business. And then I can also do these in-market audiences Google has. So you can see I have business options to target all over in here. So then I can put this in the general category of something like business technology. And I can even do business education and even business productivity software. So I've got three different business categories I've saved in here. So now that'll give me the ability to actually get my ads to show a lot. So I want as many views as possible on my ads. So I'm going to do this first with a US campaign. I have this US, Canada, Australia, etc. But the real opportunity doing this comes from getting those 1 cent views. Because if I want to rank organically, what I really want, I want the most views, the most minutes watched for the least cost. So how do I do that? Global ads.